invite Dr. Saili Jahagirdar. This is an educational grant from Acumentis, and the topic for her lecture is novel non-hormonal treatment for the uterine fibroids.
A very good afternoon to all of you. Novel non-hormonal treatment for uterine fibroids. As you all know, uterine fibroids are benign tumors developing in the wall of the uterus. Around 40% of women in reproductive age group have fibroids. The current options for treatment of fibroids are limited. It's either medical management or the surgical management or the hormonal or the non-hormonal. Now, this uterine fibroids, they're the most commonest cause of hysterectomy. There's the most common indication of hysterectomy, and around 41% of women having fibroids undergo hysterectomy. But there are a few patients who don't want this choice of hysterectomy, or they look for non-hormonal therapy. So looking at the history of treatment of fibroids, initially fibroids have both estrogen as well as progesterone receptors. These play a vital role in the development of fibroid. There are more in number of fibroids when compared to the normal myometrium. Both these estrogen and progesterone bind to their receptors and increase different growth factors, cause proliferation of fibroid cells, and inhibit apoptosis of fibroid cells. There is a need of a novel non-hormonal therapy which acts both on estrogen as well as progesterone receptors, decreases angiogenesis, is safe, and is well tolerated. Triptorigium vilfordi is a traditional Chinese medicine used as a folk remedy in China for excessive menstrual periods and for uterine fibroids. It has been used in China for more than 400 years. The active constituent is responsible for its pharmacological activity. Triptolide has an inhibitory effect on the tumor cell proliferations. It inhibits the expression of estrogen and progesterone receptors, thus reducing estrogen and progesterone biological effects in the fibroid tissue. The decrease in anti-apoptotic factor inhibits aromatase enzyme and reversibly inhibits function of ovary, thereby inhibiting ovulation and inducing amenorrhea. So it has two actions. One is reduction of the fibroid size, and second, decrease in menstrual blood loss. These are few of the clinical studies. When used this drug, there was 41.5% reduction in the uterine volume and a 60% shrinkage in the total uterine fibroid volume. When seeing the side effects, no abnormalities were found in blood sugar, blood lipid, kidney, and liver function test. The results of this study showed that both triptoperidium and mifepristone are as effective drug treatments for uterine fibroid. There was a significantly more reduction in the estrogen and progesterone in TW group compared to mifepristone. Studies have shown that low dose of treatment of triptoperidium is effective and safe in the non-reproductive requirement of patients with uterine fibroids. What are the benefits? There's a decrease in menstrual blood loss by around 188 ml, increase in hemoglobin levels. So there's a reduction of fibroid volume, reduction of total uterine volume, decrease in progesterone, and decrease of estradiol. So this drug gives a more physiological aspect of fibroid management, that is both by anti-fibrotic effects and anti-proliferative effects. The two other drugs which are used can be used are vitamin D and green tea. Vitamin D deficiency is associated with increased risk of fibroid. So giving the correct dose of vitamin D is definitely going to reduce the risk. Vitamin D supplementation also reduces progression of the extensive disease in fibroid patients. Green tea reduces fibroid size and also reduces the severity of symptoms in fibroid patients. So the non-hormonal therapy, this drug has three drugs: triptoridium vilfordi, green tea extract, and vitamin D3. Triptoridium will decrease fibroid volume, decrease uterine volume, and decrease blood loss. Green tea has an anti-proliferative action on fibroids. Vitamin D3 has anti-fibrotic actions. The indications of non-hormonal fibroid management are symptomatic management of uterine fibroids, and also it helps in reduction in the preoperative size of the fibroid. Summary: the clinical efficacy of this non-hormonal treatment is similar to hormonal therapy. It reduces fibroid size and volume. It controls anemia due to decrease in menorrhagia. Menstruation resumes after stoppage of therapy. It suppresses disease progression, improves health-related quality of life, and is safe and well-tolerated. Thank you.